from a local vegan restaurant. I was just blown away by how amazing the flavor was and how good the texture was. For me, I wouldn't have even known that I should be like grinding up seitan and then turning it into a burger patty. With seitan, it's made from wheat gluten, for those of you that don't know. It's not great for those with a gluten allergy, but for those who do not have it, I think for me, it's the closest to a meat substitute texturally. It's one of those burgers that you would crave or like think about, which is really rare with something that's like vegetarian or vegan. So I'm really excited to show you my version with chorizo seitan and a bunch of other vegetables that I mixed in. So let's head to the kitchen and then let's get started.
Okay, so I started off with an 8-ounce package of chorizo seitan, or seitan, and it's a little bit of a cheat because all of the flavors are actually already inside, and you can see that it crumbles very much like meat, so it's a great option on top of like tacos or, I don't know, stir fry, other types of things. I put in a medium onion and then also some olives for brininess, and then now I am putting in one stalk of celery, and then this is just mayo. So this is vegan mayo that tastes exactly like mayo. It is probably the best substitution ever. I mean, obviously there's still some fats in it, so you shouldn't have too much, but great substitute. I put in a tablespoon of ketchup and then a teaspoon of Worcestershire sauce. And I made this one myself. It doesn't have the anchovies in it, so I'll put a link down below for the recipe for that. And then I'm just going to blend it and then pulse it until I get the right consistency. So I didn't want a really big mash, so at the end I started kind of pulsing it to keep a little bit of the chunks there. I'm adding in about 2 tablespoons of lemon juice and then a dash of salt just for the flavoring, just to bring everything together. Then I'm adding in 1 tablespoon of dill, but you can do rosemary or other herbs that you like. This is 1/3 cup of ground up oats, and that is going to kind of act as flour and just bring everything together. There's not too much filler in this, but this will kind of bind everything together. Next, I'm taking the top blade for the food processor, and this is when it is really nice to have this while you're making these burgers, because I'm just going to kind of grate one medium zucchini up top. And I like zucchini because as it cooks down, it softens, so it becomes kind of part of a burger versus kind of you having these really like big chunks of vegetable like this carrot. But that adds a nice sweetness to it. So you can see that these are nice big strips, but it actually tastes really good when all of the vegetables are all ground up as well. So your choice, mix and match. And then I'm just gonna take a spoon. You should probably do this in a bigger container, but I'm just mixing everything together so that the vegetables are evenly dispersed. And then I took a green scoop. I don't remember how big that was, but because this doesn't have a lot of binder in it, I want to make sure to pack it really tightly because it is pretty easy to fall apart. And then I took some breadcrumbs, and then this is kind of an optional step because I sort of like it without breadcrumbs as well, but I thought that this would add a nice bit of crunch to it. So just really pack it up really tightly and then be kind of careful as you're putting in the breadcrumbs up on top, because again, it breaks pretty easily. And then at this stage, you wanna just gently smush it down with your hands, or you can actually even freeze this at this point. And then to prepare them, I actually enjoy pan frying them because I think it has a nice crispier layer outside, which I think makes a total difference with kind of these meatless burgers. So over medium, medium high heat, I fried it over a little bit of olive oil. I'd say about 2 to 3 minutes each side. So you can see it has a really nice kind of golden brown color when it's done, and it has a nice crunchy crust as well, because the inside is softer and has that nice meaty texture too to the seitan. This is just a mix that I made with the just mayo and then the ketchup. I have my tomatoes and my spinach, of course, and that makes just all sandwiches look awesome. It broke apart a little bit, but I will be a little bit more careful next time. But you can really see it's a really nice moist burger because there's a lot of like vegetables, there's a lot of moisture in it, and it's just really yummy with those little chunks of chorizo seitan. Provides great flavor. As usual, guys, if you like recipes like these and want to see more, please hit like and subscribe, and go and have yourself a seitan burger. Until next time, bye!